What's up guys, it's Amelia. Welcome back to my channel. I am so excited for the response that I got from my first video ever. I was super, super nervous about it and terrified, but I got people on my side and I have people who watched my video and subscribed and liked, and I'm just so thankful for you guys. That is so amazing. Thank you so much for supporting me and watching what I love to do. This week has been a long week for me, let me just say. I don't know about anybody else, but I'm tired. I just want a burger and a milkshake. But anyways, today in my video, I did a rose cut crease moment today. If you would like to learn how to do this beautiful, lovely cut crease, then keep on watching. So I figured for the first portion of my video, when I do my primer foundation, just basically the whole base of my face, I would leave all of the information of the products that I use in the description box below that has all the information that you'll need. I definitely talked through these steps in my first video, so if you want to find out the full details of that, you can go ahead and check out my first video for that. Today I'm going to be focusing heavily on the eyes, so I'm going to be talking through each step of the eyes in detail. So I went ahead and did my eyebrows off camera, beauty gurus. Now I'm going in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Liquid Lip in the shade Seraphine. I'm applying that all over the lid with a blending brush. I'm going to take that right above the crease and create the shape that I want. For this cut crease look, I want a little bit of a rounder shape, but I am pulling it out past the eye a little bit. I'm then taking that same brush and I'm pulling the product
up at the top and blending it out. Next, going in with the NYX Liquid Suede Lips in the shade Vintage, and I'm putting that right on the lid just to deepen the color a little bit. I'm going in with that same setting powder that I used in the beginning called Maybelline Master Fix Setting Powder and setting the liquid lips on the eyes. Next, I'm going in with the Maybelline Master Conceal. That's going to be in the shade Fair. With a synthetic brush, I'm going to start carving out my cut crease with the concealer. So I start at the corner of my eye and work my way up and out. I have hooded eyes, so I go just above my crease. I'm taking this product and I'm packing it on. So I'm going to let it dry here and there and then continuing on by packing on that product just to thicken it and make it a little bit lighter. I then go ahead and take my finger and blend the end of that cut crease into the rest of my eyelid to create a smooth gradient transition. Because I used a liquid lip, it's gonna bleed through the concealer. And I'm packing that all over the lid just to lighten it up a bit and set the liquid lips. Next, I'm going in with Sanctuary to transition the cut crease into the outer portion of my lid. Next, I'm going in with Sabbath and lightly pressing that into the outside corner and blending it into the transition shade just to deepen up that look and define it a little bit more. I'm also blending out all of the colors together with a clean blending brush. Next, I'm going in with the Maybelline Color Tattoo. This is a liquid eye chrome. It's in the shade Silver Spark. So I'm just taking a fine tipped brush and outlining my cut crease, starting at the inner corner and working my way to the middle of my eyelid. Pretty sure I drew it a little bit too high up on the other eye, but we can't all be perfect. I'm going in with the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk just to open up the eyes on the waterline a little bit. I'm then taking that same transition shade I used on the lid in Sanctuary and blending that down on my lower lash line. Next, I'm taking a powder brush and just brushing off all of that setting powder that was sitting on top of my skin. Now I'm going in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Aurora Glow Kit. I'm using the shade Luna with a wet brush just so it gives it a brighter look and the pigments are more powerful than they would naturally be. I'm going in on my inner corner as well as my brow bone. I also take the highlight right down the bridge of my nose and right at the tip of my nose as well. Next, I'm going in with the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner in the shade Trooper. I'm going to be creating a winged liner. The best way to achieve this is to hold your mirror at a lower angle, that way you can see exactly what you're doing. So I typically start at the inner corner and I work my way outwards. I carve out the bottom part of the wing and then starting back at the middle of the wing, I pull it back towards the middle of my eye to create a sharp wing. I go ahead and fill in the lines. Next, I'm going in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Blush Kit. I mix three shades together using Coastline, Terrace, and Breeze. I'm just taking my mascara and blending my lashes. I'm pretty sure I'm using the L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara. Just popping on my favorite lashes. These are the Wispy Lashes from the Sephora House of Lashes. I'm going in with the same liquid lip that I used on my eyelid, the NYX Liquid Suede in the shade Vintage. I love this color and I think it just pulls the look together perfectly. I'm taking the same highlight I used before, just brushing it up on my cheekbones and my upper lip. And well, there you have it. This would be my rose cut crease. Honestly, I don't know how I ended up creating this look. I don't know how I came up with it, but I love it, and I hope you love it too. Make sure to subscribe, like, everything will be in the description box below.